there's a lot of fiction out there, and what everybody has to realize is that our normal safety testing procedure at the laboratory, so to speak, the proving grounds where we typically set up our impacts and get the data, that was done differently because of COVID and because of the backlog at that facility. So we went and we did that test at Talladega at a real racetrack. So what everybody needs to understand is when we were able to do that testing and any safety testing that we do, there are reams of data that come off of that. And we, as far as the time frame goes, it always takes a while to piece together a complete report on what we saw in a crash. So it's not like anybody should have expected that we would go crash that car and like look at a couple of graphs and say, hey, we're done analyzing this data. We see absolutely nothing in the data that's alarming, but we want to have a comprehensive report. And I have no idea how all of the rumors started about that it didn't go well, because it did go well. So that's where we are. And hopefully we can get that report out. I'm not sure. I haven't talked to John and seen where they are with that and, you know, it being presented to everyone. But, I mean, it shouldn't be too much longer. But to expect that was going to happen in a day or two was unrealistic to begin with. And maybe we should have communicated that better up front. It's not like because it's taken time, it's not good. That's obviously how all the rumors get started. So we might have should have at the told everyone up front, you know, don't expect a comprehensive report because it takes time. So that's where we are with that.
One more thing tied to that. So there's no punting the car until 23 or all that stuff.
No, sir.
Things, timelines are still on as they should be?
Absolutely.